Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning, people of God. Good morning. This is a day that the Lord has made. Let us, that means me and you, let us rejoice and be glad about it. Come on, let us rejoice and be glad in it. Let us remember that the Lord our God is good, that he is a strong tower. Come on, the young man of God texted me this morning. Good morning, Myra. I miss your face, woman of God. Good morning. I miss y'all. It's good to see you. The man of God texted me this morning, y'all. He said, I have never seen the righteous forsaken. Come on. Yeah. God, I bless your name. And I text him back and said, nor his seed begging for bread. My God, God is going to be with us and we shall have what we need. It is the report of the Lord. Hallelujah. Concerning his children. Now, I have a word from the Lord on today. if you are new to the Makeover Ministry. So you remember, don't forget, Mondays, good morning, Philadelphia. Mondays, our schedule has changed at the Makeover Ministry. Mondays, we will not be live at 7 a.m. So on Mondays, I'll just go live as the Lord leads. So don't forget, okay? Whew. My God, I love the Lord. He is so good. So don't forget, Mondays, I'll just go live as the Lord leads. We will not be live at our 7 a.m. But the rest of the week, we will be live 7, 8. Lord, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, we'll be live at 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. All right? So don't forget. Listen. Whew, my God. Now, let me ask this question. Did y'all do y'all's Holy Ghost homework? Because some of y'all did not turn it in. If you did, I did not see it. All right. Okay. Amen. If you did not turn in your Holy Ghost homework from over the weekend, some of y'all did. Some of y'all did an amazing job. I mean, I have got some beautiful vision boards. So your homework was to do a vision board and turn it in by Monday. That was to get you a poster board and write the vision. The Word of God says write the vision and make it plain. So I received, some people did virtual vision boards. Some people did actual piece of paper ones. I like the piece of paper because I think it just really lets you go all in. But then some people turned in some amazing virtual ones also. But the ones that were handwritten, I mean, it was just really detailed. It was beautiful, y'all. Those who did, not a lot of people did y'all's Holy Ghost homework, but some did, and you did an amazing job. Now, let me not delay. So there is a word from the Lord on today, y'all. I mean, as the Lord began speaking, I was like, wow. All right. So, Lord, we thank you for the word on today, God. We ask that you send it with power and with demonstration. Put wings on the word and let it touch the hearts and the minds of your children in Jesus' name. Hallelujah and amen. There is a word from the Lord on today. This word is strategic. This word is for the prodigal children and the wayward children. This is a very strategic message. The prodigal children and the wayward children of whose parents are preaching the gospel, teaching the gospel, but most importantly are living the gospel. Okay, this message is for the PKs, the wayward children whose parents are preaching the gospel, teaching the gospel, and most importantly are living the gospel. This word is for you, for the wayward children. The Lord said, this is not the season to stay out of the will of God. It could cost you your life. And I've seen it. When the first one I heard of, I said, my God, come on, because you know the truth. When you know the truth, you are now accountable for the truth. And so as the Lord began ministering this word to me, it was a very heavy word. You cannot know the truth of God and stay out of the will of God. When your parents are people of God and they are living in a way, you're already a target for the enemy. But when you live your life outside of the will of God and you know your parents are in the will of God and you're choosing to live any kind of way, the Word of God says, honor thy mother and thy father and thy days shall be longer on the face of the earth. Now, you know your mama's a woman of God. You know your daddy's a man of God and they don't want you to be out doing all kind of things. You're not honoring them. So now you're giving the devil full access to take your life. The Word of God says, honor thy mother and thy father, that days shall be longer on the face of the earth and things will go well with you. So when you know, when your parents are living, I'm talking about y'all kids, my God, mostly the adult children who know the truth, whose parents are good and oily, the anointing drips off their robe as they walk. My God, come on. This is not the same. You are a direct target for the enemy, but you have given him access to your life by not honoring your mother and your father. The word of God says the truth shall set you free. Now, let me give you scripture so that you know that this is the word of God and not my word. Hebrews 10 and 26 says, dear friends, if we deliberately continue sinning, after we have received the knowledge of the truth, if we keep on sinning after you know the truth and you have been told the truth, my God, there is no longer any sacrifice that will cover these sins. That scripture just, you know the truth. The word of God says there is no longer any sacrifice that will cover these sins. There is only the terrible expectation of God's judgment and raging fire that will consume his enemies. For anyone who refused to obey the law of Moses was put to death without mercy. If you didn't obey the law of Moses, that's one thing. And they said you was put to death without mercy. It wasn't no anesthesia. It was a rough, brutal thing. Was put to death without mercy on the testimony of two or three witnesses. As long as two or three people seen you do it and they told on you, it was over. If you broke the law of Moses, just think how much worse. God, I bless your name. The punishment will be for those who have trampled on the Son of God and who have treated the blood of the covenant, which made us holy, as if it were common and unholy, and have disdained and insulted the Holy Spirit who brings God's mercy to us. You heard the word of God. You have seen the word of God lived out through your parents' life, and you still want to go. Your mama's pleading the blood. Your daddy's pleading the blood. They oiling you up, down, and sideways. My God, come on. They interceding for you, and you are treating the things that are holy as if, oh, her, that's just mama. That's just daddy. Her they go praying again. Here they go in tongues again. Huh. You are treating the blood of the covenant, which made us holy, as if it were common and unholy, and have insulted and disdained the Holy Spirit. God, I bless your name. This is a serious warning to those prodigals who are out living their own kind of way. Who you know your mama has told you the truth. Not only have they told you, your daddy has told you the truth. Not only have they told you and they preach the gospel, but they live with clean hands. They not behind closed doors sleeping with people that don't have no business. They not behind closed doors drinking and getting drunk. They not behind closed doors smoking weed. They not behind closed doors calling you everything but a child of God. They are living the truth. And you are deliberately going your own way. The word of the Lord is turn back and live. And see, when the Lord began ministering this word to me, I'm like, I promise you, as he impressed it upon my heart, it's a serious word. I had to go and talk to my own children first. I had to go talk to, hey, let me talk. I can't even bring the word. And I sat on the word for a moment. And then the Lord reminded me of the word of God in Ezekiel when he said, when I give my prophets a word, you go give that word immediately. As the Lord began to impress this upon me, this is going to be the difference between life and death for some PKs. Now, a lot of them are going to go past it. Oh, because they consider the word of God as common. They're taking the word of God as lightly. Oh, that's just somebody, another preacher. Oh, honey, I was raised in church. I don't need to hear all that. They're taking the word of God and they're taking the blood of the covenant, which made us holy, and they are treating it common and unholy. It's dangerous. Many will go past this, but a couple, their life will be saved. The word of the Lord is turn back and live. Let's go to Hebrews 12. Hebrews 12. God, you're faithful. Hallelujah to the Lamb. My God. Thank you, Jesus. Wait a minute. Give me a second, y'all. Okay. Hebrew 12 and verse 16 says, make sure no one is immoral or godless like Esau, who traded his birthright as the firstborn son for a single meal. You know that afterwards, when he wanted his father's blessing, my God, he was rejected. Most translations say he was hated. My God, he was rejected, and it was too late for repentance. See, as I was like, Lord, you know, well, your word says the seed of the righteous shall be delivered, but he had to help me understand. But there comes a time, don't exceed grace. There comes a time when they got to make a choice for themselves. Choose this day whom you will serve. There is, I know we like to say all the time, oh God, you know, whenever you come back to God, you might not make it back. The word of the Lord is it was too late for Esau. Don't run out of time. I'm talking to the waywards who are thinking that I'm just going to party a little bit more. I'm just going to smoke a little bit more. I'm just going to lay up a little bit more. I'm going to have a little bit more fun, and then I'm going to come back to God. The word of the Lord said for Esau, it was too late, even though he begged with bitter tears. This is a warning. This is a warning. If you know a PK who is wayward, just send it to him anyway. It don't matter if they listen to it. The blood won't be on your hand. My God, come on. Turn back and live. This is the report of the Lord. God, I bless your name. My God. Hallelujah. Let's go to Romans. Just keep holding tight, y'all. I love God. I said, God, this word is going to be the difference between literal. Some children of God or godly parents are going to lose their life behind it. I've already seen it happen. The first one that I heard of, I knew it instantly hit my heart. And I said, my God, her mother was a woman of God. She's ignored all the instruction of her mother. She has ignored, she's lived her own way. And this, and it cost her life. Come on, we have to understand this is the word of the Lord. The word of the Lord has the highest precedence in our life. Honor thy mother and thy father, and thy days shall be longer on the face of the earth. Let's go to Romans 9. God, I bless your name. Romans 9 and verse 11. Hallelujah. But before they were born, before they had done anything good or bad, she received a message from God. We're talking about Rebecca. She received a message from God. This message shows that God chooses people according to his own purpose. See, God chooses people according to his own purpose. You don't get to choose why God created you. My God. You don't get to choose why God has created you. He calls people, but not according to their good or their bad. Come on. She was told your older son will serve your younger son. In the words of the scripture, I love Jacob, but I rejected Esau. My God. Are we saying then that God was unfair? Of course not. For God said to Moses, I will show mercy to anyone I choose. See, this is the piece that I'm going to make it back. You know, I'm just going to do a little bit more when I'm ready. When I'm ready, God going to change my heart. No, the word is going out. See, the word of God says, humble yourself. Many times when children are raised in a household with God, with the godly things, they learn how to be religious. They have a religious spirit. They talk, my God, they talk the talk of God, but they live how they want to live. And they say, oh, well, you know, God will keep his hand on me. He's God. You know, you just keep praying for me. You just keep, come on. No, the word of the Lord says, I will show mercy to anyone I choose. And I will show compassion to anyone I choose. So it is God who decides to show mercy. We can neither choose it nor work for it. Don't exceed grace. There is a time where you're beyond repentance. Don't go beyond repentance. My God, come on. This is a call of repentance. Turn back and live. This word is to all of the prodigal children. And you know who you are. Don't nobody even need to tell you. You know who you are. You can lose your life. You're going to lose things, but you might lose your life behind this word. Because it's not my word. It is the word of the Lord. And now I got the next piece of this is the Lord said there is a changing of guards happening. Because many people are like, huh, I'm so tired of hearing her preach. I'm so tired of hearing him preach. I'm so tired of them keep coming to me telling me to live right. I'm so tired of me just this. I'm so tired of this. How her she come. Her holier than thou come. Don't worry. There's a changing of guards because the Lord is switching. He's giving out new assignments. And because many people have not listened, the Lord is going to turn the hearts. The Bible says he turns the hearts of kings. He is getting ready to do some heart turning. And so the very people that have been on our minds in the midnight hour, you up praying, interceding for them people, God is getting ready to make them to you just as common as the paint on this wall. Like, child, you don't even, because I've shared the word, I've lived the word, I've preached, prayed, prophesied to you, lay hands on you, cast three devils out of you, done all of those things, and there's no fruit on the tree. And so God is getting ready to change the hearts of the teachers and give them new students. But the dangerous part about that is you're getting ready to be turned over. You're getting ready to be turned over to those things that you are choosing besides God. And I pray that you make your way back. See, some are not going to make their way back. Somebody is going to cost them their life. Some are not going to make it their way back. And some are going to make it back by the skin of their teeth. I mean, it's going to be so. They're going to be, whew, my God. You don't want that for them. But it is the report of the Lord. Let me give you scripture. Let me give you scripture. God, I bless your name. Thank you, Lord. Oh, God, you're blessed and you're holy. Romans 1 and verse 24. So God abandoned them to do whatever shameful things their hearts desire. Okay. God abandoned them. I know we don't like these kind of scriptures because they didn't choose God. Verse 21 says, yes, they knew God. They was raised in church. Come on. They heard the word of the Lord preach. Come on. They mama been in there. They daddy been in there. They know. They knew God, but they wouldn't worship him as God or even give him thanks. My God, this is so serious. I promise you, if you are a prodigal child or a wayward child and you are out of the will of God, this is not the time to stay out. It's dangerous. It is a battle zone coming out there. It's a battle in the spirit, and you don't want these problems. Listen, there's a target on your back already when your mother and your father preach the gospel. It's already a target on your back. My God, come on. But the blood is covering you because you have to stay under the blood. You can't keep getting out of the ark of safety, my God, and then still want to be covered. And then when everything's falling apart, mama, pray for me, daddy, pray for me. It don't work like that. This is the time where God is calling you. It's a changing of guards. You have to step up to the plate and call on the name of the Lord for yourself. My God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Whew. God, I bless your name. Don't exceed grace. You know, when the Lord gave me a word like this back in November, he gave me a word and it came to pass. The Lord said, when the people cross over into 2022, if they have not washed their robes, and it was a direct word for marriages, if people have not turned from their wicked ways and their marriages, we're getting ready to have divorces break out in the land. And we've been seeing it. We've been seeing it at the top. So when you see it at the top is a big reflection of the little things going on behind closed doors. Because we can't see all this, but we got Cora Jakes. That's T.D. Jakes' daughter. We got Devon Franklin and Megan Good. They getting a divorce. And it's another couple. I can't think of that name. It's another big couple in the gospel who are getting a divorce. So you have to be mindful of the word of God. Don't take it lightly. I promise, don't take it lightly. Whew. He is not a man that he shall lie, nor the son of man that he shall repent. And the last piece that I have of this word is about spiritual children. So the Lord just blessed me with this word last night. You know, a lot of times, exactly, yep, that's who it was. Yep. A lot of times When I think about spiritual parents and spiritual children, I always think about how God gives spiritual parents because the natural parents aren't spiritual. And that is true. But the Lord also helped me to understand. He said, I will supply all of your needs according to my riches and glory. And so he even helped me understand last night. I even give spiritual children because natural children aren't spiritual. And I was like, you know what, God, that's okay. My God, because you got to be able to see some fruit. The Bible says hope deferred makes the heart sick. Come on. And so when the people of God have been preach, praying, prophesying, my God, they're pouring out, but their own children are going by the wayside and they out and they getting, they doing all kind of stuff. They doing whatever. They're taking the grace of God for granted. Come on. The Lord puts spiritual children in our lives to be like a well of refreshing water. Let me give you Bible. Let's go to First Samuel. Let's go to First Samuel. Thank you, Jesus. 1 Samuel chapter 2. God, I bless your name. Chapter 2, verse 12. We're talking about Eli and his sons. Now, the sons of Eli were scoundrels who had no respect for the Lord or for their duties as priests. Okay. So now it goes on to talking about how they were stealing the sacrifice. Okay. Verse 17, let's go down to verse 17. The sins of these young men was so serious in the Lord's sight that they treated the Lord's offering with contempt. But Samuel. Now, Samuel was Eli's spiritual son. But Samuel, though he was only a boy, served the Lord. He wore a linen garment that looked like a priest. Okay, so he served the Lord. And even the Bible says in verse 21, the second portion says, Samuel grew up in the presence of the Lord. Come on. He grew up in the presence of the Lord. So because Eli had sons, but his natural sons was just doing the most. They weren't able to carry the oil, but that oil's got to be passed down. The Lord created an opportunity, my God, through Samuel for it to be his spiritual son so that oil could be caught somewhere. There had to be some purity. So when he says, I shall supply all your needs according to my riches and glory, sometimes we're looking, we want it all to be natural, but God creates a family of faith. He creates every situation that we need. He creates every situation that we need. He creates everything that we need to understand. But we sometimes are limiting God because we want it to come from our natural mother or our natural father, or we want it to come from this source, or we want it to come. Quit, take the limits off of the source and take the supply. Okay, take the limits off of the source where it's coming from and just take the supply, whichever one it is. All right. Hallelujah. My God, I love the Lord. I love the Lord. I love the Lord. So I wanted to make sure that this message got out because it is truly a word. It is a call from the throne room of heaven. I don't like to give words like this, but in the right hands, people will turn from their wicked ways. But the sad part is many won't. Many will not. Actually, you know what? I'm glad you did bring up John. That's not where I'm going to go to John 8. But that was definitely the Holy Ghost because it was a scripture I wanted to read that I didn't write down. But it just came to mind. Let's go to John 8. Thank you, Lord. God, I bless your name. Let's go to John 8. Hallelujah. All right, so Jesus is talking to a crowd of people. All right, we'll start at verse 31. Let me give you we'll take this whole piece and then we'll wrap it up. John 8:31, Jesus said to the people who believed in him, "You are truly my disciples if you remain faithful to my teaching." See, there's a distinction. And the children of God, because they were raised in the things of God, they know the jargon. They know the language. They know how to say, "Oh, God is good. You know, God's grace, his mercy. Oh, mama, don't worry. His blood is covering me." But you fornicating. But you lying, you cheating, you stealing, you masturbating. Come on. You're smoking weed, you're drinking, you're doing drugs, you popping pills, you out at the nightclub. Come on, wait a minute. No, he said, if you're truly mad, you remain faithful to my teaching and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. But we are descendants of Abraham. They said that, I'm gonna break it down into today's words. We are children of God. They said, we have never been slaves to anyone. What do you mean? You will be set free. What you mean? Oh, I know the word of God. My mama preached, my daddy preached. Oh, you don't got to come telling me no word of God. I know the Bible. Jesus replied, I tell you the truth. Anyone who is still a slave of sin, a slave is not a permanent member of the family, but a son is a part of the family forever. So if the son sets you free, you are truly free. And yes, I realize you are descendants of Abraham. Yes, I realize your mama go to church. I realize your daddy go to church. I realize all your children, your brothers and sisters, they go to church. I realize all of that. I realize you go on, even go sometime, every now and again. I realize that. Yet, some of you are trying to kill me because there's no room in your heart for my message. There is no room in your heart for my message. When your heart is so contaminated with lust and drugs and gluttony and greed and harm and evil and wickedness, all of those things. When your heart is so full of everything else, he said, you trying to kill me. What does that mean? You trying to shut me up. Not with an actual knife, but you're trying to hurt. Okay, ma'am, hurry up. What are you trying to say? No, I don't want no pamphlets. I don't want to talk about God. I don't need the prayer. You trying to kill me, my God, because there's no room in your heart. There is no room in your heart for the message, my God, of Christ. I'm telling you what I saw when I was with my father, but you are following the advice. You're following the leadership, my God, of your father. Help us, Holy Ghost. You are following the advice of your father. Our father is Abraham. We children of God. That's what they're saying. They declared, no. The Lord helped them understand, no, you're not. No, Jesus replied, for if you were really the children of Abraham, you would follow his examples. This is why, as much as we don't like it, spiritual children, the Lord is showing us. He said, no, they're birthed out of that, what that oil of the teacher, the mother, the father, my God, come on. They're birthed out of that oil, because if you was of that oil, you would be following the examples of that oil. Come on. You would be looking like your daddy. God, I bless your name. For if you were really the children of Abraham, you would follow his examples. Instead, you trying to kill me. Instead, you are trying to kill me because I told you the truth. Come on. Instead, when I'm on here talking about sin, people's on here trying to block me. They stay blocking me on TikTok. My God, come on. I'm just telling you, he said, instead, you're trying to kill me because I told you the truth, which I heard from God. I have lost friends over preaching this gospel, which I heard from God. They love to say, oh, you judgmental, honey. You want me to come around and when the time that you want me. I'm going to come around when I come around, not when you want me to come around. It ain't about what I want. Listen, this is the truth that I heard from God. No, you are imitating your real father. Abraham never did such a thing. Abraham didn't act like that. I know you saying that's who your mama is. I know you saying that's who your daddy is. My God, come on. But they don't act like that. You're imitating your real father. God, I bless your name. We just talked about yesterday how in We're talking about how in Timothy, how Paul told Timothy, I became your father, your spiritual father, my God. When I, he said, I became your spiritual father when I began to preach the gospel to you, when you begin to see how I live. And that is the same with sin. When you begin to sit up under, my God, sinful teaching, when they teach you how to roll a blunt, they teach you how to have sex, they teach you how to dress naked, they teach you how to cuss somebody out, they teach you how to do all these things, you come under their tutelage, my God, and then you're subject to the spirit, God, I bless your name, that is giving them their advice, my God, and you're now listening to it, and you're now under the influence, and now you are a part of that oil. Because just like holy oil runs down, evil oil runs down too. Because the devil is an impersonator. Come on. Because the devil is an impersonator. My God. Come on. The word of God says he's a copycat. Come on. He's an imitation. Come on. He's a counterfeit. My God. He's not the real thing. And if you know anything about this counterfeit stuff that's going on nowadays, these counterfeit people, oh, they are, when they making counterfeit money and counterfeit purses and counterfeit shoes and all of this stuff, it look real. Like, you gotta really have a trained eye. You gotta really have a trained eye. My God. I love God and all his children. Hallelujah. Give me 1 second. Let's stay on focus. Maybe you're new to makeover ministry, but you don't get to come on. We in one direction. We in one direction. Don't come on here trying to, you got to teach your own Bible study on your own page. If you adding to, then let's add to. We're not pulling away from. Listen. They replied, we are illegitimate children. God himself is our true father. People will argue you down. They will argue they're on a stripper pole. They on their page, butt naked, everything hanging out. They in their blunts, blacks, got 3 and 4 chicks at the same time. Oh, no, I'm a child of God. You can't tell me no different. No, I'm going to heaven. Okay. All right. Jesus told them, if God were your father, you would love me. If God were your father, you would love me. Come on, when you are truly a child of God, you love the people of God who have the spirit of God. If God were your father, you would love me because I come to you from God. I'm not here on my own. People don't realize that. When you are being sent by God, when you're being sent by God, you're not on your own. I don't even want to call you with this man. Here she go again. I'm so sick of her. I don't even want to talk to you. Come on. Especially when you got to give the word of God to people who are hard-headed and rude and ignorant and fool. You don't even want to do it. Come on. Trust and believe I am sent. If I was not sent, I would not be here. I love God and all his children. If I could choose my way, I would just be around all the people that truly love God, that just wanted to come by themselves, and that's it. That would just bless me. But that's not how it is. Because when we're sent, but if you truly love God, you will love me. Because I'm not here on my own. He sent me. Why can't you understand what I'm saying? It's because you can't even hear me. For you are the children of your father, the devil. You love to do the evil things he does. When the Lord began to make that word plain to me, because I had to see myself, and I'm like, oh, I love God. I'm a child of God. I dance for God. I minister to the children's ministry. You know, I love God. He said, no, get that right there. You are a child of the devil when you love to do the evil things he does. Take the word evil out and put all that you like to do. You like drinking, smoking, you like lying, you like cussing, you like fornicating, you like masturbating, you like strip clubs, you like porn. Come on, you like dressing naked, you like talking smart, you like gossiping, honey, you like giving it to him like I'm just being 100. Come on, you're nasty, you're rude. Come on, he said no. For you are the children of your father, the devil. And you love to do the evil things he does. He was a murderer from the beginning, killing the truth. He was a murderer from the beginning. In the Garden of Eden, he came killing the truth. He came combating the truth that was given, my God, from the throne of heaven. God, I bless your name. He has always hated the truth. You want to know what spirit is in you? When the truth of God is being preached that you can actually read with your own eyes. When they tell you that homosexuality is wrong, fornication is wrong, drinking is wrong, all those things. When you can read it with your own eyes, my God, come on. And you are offended by it. God, I bless your name. Come on. He has always hated the truth. Why? Because there is no truth in him. When he lies, it is consistent with his character. My God. For he is a liar and the father of lies. So when I tell you the truth, you naturally don't believe me. He is the father of lies. And when he lies, it is consistent with his character. My God. Come on. I just got reminded of Abraham and Sarah. When Abraham told Sarah, don't tell them that you my wife because they're going to try to take you from me because you're so beautiful. Tell them you are my sister. Yes, that was a lie, but it wasn't consistent with his character. He wasn't always lying. He wasn't always manipulating. He wasn't always scheming. He wasn't always scamming. Listen, he said when he lied, God, I bless your name. It's consistent with his character. Ooh, for he is a liar and the father of lies. So when I tell you the truth, it's natural that you don't believe me. Baby, you better, when there's something going on in you that you have gotten to a place when you naturally don't believe the truth, just like breathing, you can reject God just like breathing. Oh my goodness, that's dangerous. And see, God allowed us to have a stubborn, there's a piece of us that is a stubborn nature, but it's not supposed to be used against God. It's supposed to be used for God. That stubborn nature that he allows, he said, I have made you like flint. Just as rebellious as I have made you just as solid, just as firm, so that you will not be moved. You will be unmovable. You will be planted, my God, by the still waters. You shall have I shall not be moved. I'm going to live by faith. I'm going to walk this thing out. I'm going to live with clean hands. I'm going to pray for my enemies. I'm going to fast. I'm going to intercede, my God. I'm going to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. But it was never meant to be used against God. Which of you can truthfully accuse me of sin? See, this is the piece. When you are called to leadership, and not even when you call to leadership, but when you just call to be a child of God, the word of God says you should live a blameless life. Examine yourself so God don't have to. You have to stay in the deliverance room. My God, you got to stay examining what has to be cut away. Humble yourself. Turn from your wicked ways every single day. Come on. So when you got to give the word, when they look back and try to tell you what you got going on, they can't find nothing. All they can say is you ugly. Well, honey, I can't do nothing about that. That's just how the Lord made my face. Come on, whichever way it goes, you have to live a blameless. Which of you can truthfully accuse me of sin? And since I'm telling you the truth, why don't you believe me? This is the piece. Anyone who belongs to God gladly listens to the word of God. But you don't listen because you don't belong to God. You don't listen because you don't belong to God. You don't listen because you don't belong to God. That's dangerous. That's scary. That's help us, Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. It's the word of the Lord. That's the report of the Lord. That's all I got today. That's all I got. I'm not even going to ask you to sow on that word. Just turn from your wicked ways. The word of the Lord for the waywards in this season is turn back and live. I want everybody to share this message. If you know that this message was the truth, I need you to share it on your Facebook, on your Instagram. I need you to share the word of the Lord. It'll be uploaded on my YouTube channel shortly. Go on there and it's going to be called Warning to the Wayward. Warning to the Way. I promise this is not the season to stay out of the will of God. I need you to share this message. It is the difference between life and death. Many are going to overlook it, but it's some PKs out there that just needed one more sign from God, and this is your sign. This is your sign. This is your sign. My God, we pray that the famine hit the land, because the word of the Lord was, when the famine hit the land, the prodigal son came home. And when I tell you, this is a real thing. Oh, yeah. Yes, this is a real thing. We have to understand, as I began to process this message, it began to break my heart. And I had to think about the Lord, because he wishes that none shall perish. Wishes that none shall perish. And when you know that, all a person got to do is turn, they give their life back to the Lord, and their life will begin to turn in a different direction. They'll be able to have peace, and they won't have to smoke weed. Come on. They'll be able to have joy, and they won't have to pop pills. Come on. The Lord will be their provider, and they ain't got to sell their body. My God. But if this word has found you, and it has pierced your heart today, and you know that you are not in right alignment, you know you are wayward, you know you got sin in your back pocket, this today is not a message about trying to point fingers and try to say who didn't teach me and what happened to me and I'm a victim. And this ain't that today. This is not that. Today, the word of the Lord is turn back and live. Turn back and live. Hallelujah. 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 The potter wants to put you back together again. Do not. Do not. I promise this is, oh God, I bless your name. I just see it in the spirit. Not too many days from now. I see it in the spirit. People are going to start, the children of the children of God are getting ready to start losing their very lives because they are not taking heed to this message. Turn back and live. Thank you, Jesus. If this word is for you, all you got to say is, God, I surrender. Wash me. Cleanse me. Make me new. I want to come home. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar. Hallelujah. The Father is waiting there. Hallelujah. Oh, come to the altar. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless your name, oh God. Hallelujah. My God. My God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, I bless your name, because the burden of sin is heavy. It crushes. I was thinking about this last night. How long will you go to nightclubs? How long will you be on the hamster wheel of nightclubs? The devil comes to kill, steal, and destroy, and we're partying with the thief. Stealing your money. Spent countless money on outfits and clothes and jewelry and hair and makeup and drinks and drugs and admission to get there and gas money and babysitters just to go to a sin pool, just to go to the devil's den, just to go to the devil's church. Let me help us. Come on. How long? Yeah. How long will you stay out of the will of God? I'm not talking about, see, many of you think you're in the will of God, but your hands are not truly clean, and you know they're not. You got, and when you've been out of the will of God, you got pride on you. You wear it like a robe. It'll cost you your life. Amen. It'll cost you your life. Because you know you're a child of God. You know you got more for you, from you, in you. I had to tell my own child this. I said, I love you. Love you. You was mama's apple of her eye. I love you. But the truth of the matter is this. Some people think that because I'm not out there smoking and drinking and partying and cussing and cheating, because I'm not out there in sin, I'm good. But you're just as much as in sin if you ain't doing your God assignment. with all your heart and all your mind and all your soul and all your strength. And the truth of the matter is, people who are workaholics and who have become so obsessed with their career and who have become so obsessed and they have selfish ambition and they're so driven by the things of this world, because it's because money is your God. And people don't like this message. Money is your God. Because you getting that money, you're obeying your master. The word of God says you cannot serve two masters. You can't serve God and money. When that money calls, aka your job, you working overtime, undertime, around the time. My God, come on. You going in early because it's overtime pay? Because money is your God. You don't have time to read your word. You don't have time to fast and pray. You don't have time to meditate. You don't have time to go witness. You don't have time to do anything because you are consumed and money is your God. I know we don't like to hear it, but it's the word of the Lord. Turn back and live. Thank you, God. Jesus is calling. Come to the altar. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, I bless your name. Thank you, Jesus. Don't exceed grace. This is a call to repent. I promise, if I could find all the people of God that I needed, I just got to have his word and just shake them and just say, please, it could cost you your life. Cost you your life. The cost of your life. Sir, somebody just said passion judgment is not of God. That's ignorant. The word of God says a prophet's mouth is of judgment. I'm a prophet. You got to find you another live this morning. I'm trying to get my phone together. Y'all give me a second. This is just crazy. All right, people of God, that's all I got. I don't even want you to sow into this word today. I just want you to live holy. I just want you to live holy. I want you to live righteous. I need you to share. All I want you to do today, I don't want nobody to sow into this word. I want you to live holy. Take a self-evaluation of yourself. But I want you to share this message on your social media platform. Share this message with anybody that you know. Share it. Send it to personal texts. I want this video to go everywhere that you can send the video. All right. It'll be uploaded on my YouTube channel very shortly. As soon as I download it, it'll be uploaded. Make sure you share it. Make sure you share it. Make sure you share it. It'll be called Warning to the Wayward. All right, people of God, I love you all. I love you all. Hallelujah. All right, so let's wrap up. What else? Our makeover ministry announcements. So we had homework assignment. We had Holy Ghost homework. And those of you who have turned your homework assignment in, y'all have done an amazing job. Those that have done an actual paper poster board assignment, y'all did a whoo. Y'all showed out. The show out was real. Y'all did an amazing job because that was the actual assignment. The actual assignment was to get a poster board and do it on a poster board. And so I really love those. Those have been so good. Those have been so good. But I've had some good virtual ones too. But that's a little bit cheating. It's a little bit cheating. Okay. But God is so faithful. So I thank God for everyone who has turned their homework in. If you have not turned it in, I need you to go ahead and turn it on in. Okay. I need you to go ahead and turn it on in if you have not. Yes. All right. So, and once you make it, then put it on your post. That's why I want you to make it on an actual poster board. The virtual one, you can't hang it up unless you print it out. So if you made a virtual vision board, then I need you to print it out and post it up. But the actual assignment was to get a poster board because I want you to put the work in on it. Okay. So people did a really, really great job on that. If you haven't turned it in, that's your assignment. Come on. Don't take the word of the Lord lightly. That's if you're saying you're a part of makeover ministry and you in the room and you're not doing your assignments, you're taking the word of the Lord lightly. All right. So we'll be back tomorrow at 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. So I did not get to, I didn't get to travel today, so I'll be traveling tomorrow after makeover ministry. Too many things. Still had too many loose ends. So I'll be traveling tomorrow. On Wednesday, I got a treat for y'all. Listen, we have a special guest. I'm so, it's going to bless you because we've been in the season and we've been talking about business and seeds and planning and working a vision and all of these things. Y'all, listen, this man of God, his business has been groomed and led by the Holy Ghost. His testimony is holy. It's going to bless you. We're going to have him to do a conference in March for our business. business owners and small business entrepreneurs, and we gonna let the Lord just do whatever he wanna do. In February, we have something coming up for our married couples called Lover's Lane. So more details are coming so that you'll be able to sign up for that. It's gonna be good too. All right, people of God, I love you all, and I pray that the Lord continue to be with you. May his countenance shine upon you and give you peace. Hallelujah and amen. Oh, wow, that's awesome. Okay, you said you got baptized yesterday. Amen, that's a blessing. That's a blessing. Amen. That's that you went down in that watery grave and came up a new creation. So that's beautiful. That's beautiful. How do you get one? How do you get one of what? I don't know what the question is. How do you get one? You say, how do I get one? Oh, how do you get one-on-one? Whew. Bless God. Just inbox me and I will send you the information. I do life coaching sessions. I do one-on-ones. So yes, if you inbox me that you want information, about the one-on-ones, then I will get with you. All right. Have a good day on purpose. Blessings and peace. I'm Apostle Julia.